Hello, so I'm Camille Marini. I'm a Chief Technology Officer at Okin, and I'm going to talk about federated learning and how it can help in healthcare to create new discoveries while preserving the privacy of sensitive medical data. So at Okin, we create knowledge from medical data using machine learning. So we work with multimodal data sets from several medical centers. And so federated learning appears as a key solution for us. This is why we created a platform in order to do federated learning. So before I detail how federated learning can help you for your research, I have a quick poll for you. So the first question in this poll is, what is the biggest challenge faced by your machine learning initiatives? Is it the volume of data? Do you have difficulties handling the large volume of data? Is it the GDPR compliant data access? Is it struggling with the collaboration with third parties? Or is it a challenge around model validation? Or because you don't have enough internal data science expertise? Or because there are some regulatory uncertainties? So indeed, there are many challenges when you want to use machine learning, when you do machine learning initiatives. And in particular, in order to create a machine learning model, you need a lot of data in order to build an efficient model. And also, you need heterogeneous data to build a robust model that can be transferred to other populations. So the standard approach to train a machine learning model on data, and especially when you want to work with data from multiple sources, because you need a lot of data and heterogeneous data, is to pull all the data in one server and to train a machine learning model on this server. However, it's not always possible, and especially in healthcare, because data are sensitive. So data are sensitive, it's because it's very often it corresponds to personal data. But also for some use cases in healthcare, it's because it's a competitive data. So data that you don't want to share with your competitors. And so for this reason, it might not be possible to pull all the data in one server. And there might be another reason why it's not a good idea to pull all the data. It's because it might cost a lot of money and it might also be kind of complex. So our solution is to keep the data stored in medical centers and make the machine learning model travel from one center to another in order to be trained. So this is why what federated learning enables. So at Okin, we've built a platform for federated learning, and we believe that it has many benefits. So the first one is that using federated learning, it's possible to increase the performance of the machine learning models that you create. Because you're going to be able to leverage multiple data sources and likely heterogeneous data. Another benefit is that you can guarantee the privacy of the data that you handle. Because of course, the data remains stored where they were collected. But also because it's possible to use a privacy enhancing techniques, which are going to make it which makes sure that the model that is created from the data do not leak properties of the data outside of your center. And the third benefit, so here it's not a benefit of federated learning itself, it's more a benefit of the solution that we found to implement federated learning, it's traceability. So I'm going to detail our solution a bit later. But basically, we trace all the operations which are done around federated learning. And we believe that this is very important to bring trust with our partners and also to be able to reproduce the results. So it's going to be possible to prove the chain, I mean, to audit the chain of operation that were done in order to create the model and to redo them if needed. And finally, the third reason why traceability can be interested for federated learning is that using traceability, it might be possible to build fair revenue sharing models. So more precisely, if we can trace the increase in performance for a training iteration, we might be able to build the contribution score of the different data sources. So it's more on a research aspect for now, but something that might be very interesting in the future. So on this slide, yeah. So on this slide, you can see an illustration of what federated learning is. So it's a typical federated learning workflow. So basically, a model is trained on data from the center A, B, and C. So an update of the model is done, and it's sent back to what is called an averaging server. So it's another node. Here, the model updates are averaged, and then they are sent back to the different centers where the data are stored. So the training continues, and then it's sent back to the averaging server, and so on and so forth. Until the convergence of the model, so until reaching interesting performances of your model. Okay, so now I have another poll question for you. So this is the following. So which statement applies to you? So all data internally is integrated, connected, and accessible across the organization. Data that I want to access is there internally, but siloed and disconnected, but I can centralize it if I need. Data that I want to access is there internally, but siloed and disconnected, and I can't centralize it. Data that I need is not available internally and only at a third-party site, but transferring it internally is challenging. Or data that I need is not available internally and only at third-party site, but transferring it internally is impossible. Or the last possibility, some data is available internally, but I want to complete it with third-party data that I can't easily access. So in our case at Okin, it's a statement number five. So data we need to work with are not available internally, but only at third-party sites, and it's not possible for us to transfer it internally. And indeed, so we have a large network of partners so providing data. So we work with 55 research organizations and hospitals, with more than 100 key opinion leaders, and this makes it possible for us to work with data for more than 700,000 patients. And it's not possible for us to of course, to centralize this data because it's highly sensitive data. So for us, it's statement number five. And so this is the reason why we had to build a federated learning solution in order to be able to work with data from our partners. So this federated learning solution is called Okin Connect. So it's an end-to-end platform for federated learning, which is built around three key pillars. So which are collaboration. So it makes it possible to collaborate with one or multiple partners providing data and data scientists in order to generate new insights. The second key pillar is compliance. So because partners are gonna keep the control over their data because the data are gonna remain stored on their server. So they have a full control over what is done with their data. And the third key pillar is confidentiality. So of course, with the privacy aspect, so data do not move. And also, we use some privacy enhancing techniques that we have integrated within our product to make sure that no properties of the data, neither of the data can leak outside of a center. So on this slide, you can see a description of our stack. So let's start with the compute resources, so which are the corresponding to the hardware. So our stack can be either deployed on-premise, but also in the cloud. And so usually it's a responsibility for our clients to manage its computing resources and its server. So on top of this, we deploy a Kubernetes cluster, which makes it possible then to deploy our product, which is called Hawking Connect, on top of this Kubernetes cluster. And so Hawking Connect so is a complete solution for federated learning. So the core of it is called Substra. It's something to manage the computation. And on top of it, we have a Connect library and a graphical user interface. And you could see a screenshot in the previous slide. So on this slide, we zoom in into the Connect solution. I'm just gonna repeat what I said before. So at the core of it, there is an open source framework that we have developed at Hawking, which is called the Substra framework. And so it's open source and within it, we have implemented something to have a full traceability of what's happening on the platform. And in order to do this, we use a distributed ledger technology, which is called Hyperledger Fabric. On top of it, we have a Connect. We have a federated learning library, which makes it possible to implement several federated learning strategies without recoding them. And with some built-in privacy-preserving approaches. And of course, on top of it, at Hawking, we have, I mean, we can also provide some data science expertise. So meaning that we have a full lab of data scientists and we're used to working with data and federated learning. So I'm gonna switch this one because I think I'm a bit late. And I'm going to jump directly into some use cases. So the first use case is called HealthChain. So HealthChain is a project with several hospitals in France where we have deployed Hawking Connect. So for this use case, I mean, we try to develop some machine learning models in order to predict treatment responses in breast cancer and melanoma. So we work with the hospitals. You can see their logo here, Institut Curie, Centre Hospitalier de Nantes and Saint-Léon-Bérard. So if for this use case, we have deployed on-prem in the hospitals, and the Hawking nodes is deployed in the cloud on GCP. For this use case, it's our data scientist at Hawking who develop the machine learning models. And in order to do so, for this use case, they have access. So we have a solution of remote data access where they can get access to part of the data. Another use case is called Melody. So there is a presentation on Melody a bit later in the other track of this conference. So Melody is a different type of use case. So here we are using Connect in order to do federated learning for drug discovery. So we work with data from 10 pharmaceutical companies. So you can see their logo there, here. Connect is deployed in the cloud on AWS. For this use case, it's a data scientist from two universities, so K11 and BME, who design the algorithms. And for this use case, there is no access to the data because, as you can guess, it's a drug discovery data, so highly sensitive data. So there is no way we can get access to the data in order to be able to design the machine learning model. And before I stop the presentation, I think there is a last question. So, which I see federated learning as a solution that can address this real need internally. Statement number one, compliant access and use of patient data for machine learning. Connecting internal, statement number two, connecting internal data silos. Number three, rapidly testing my models on external data. Statement number four, collaborating with third parties where sharing data is hard, impossible. Five, all of the above, and six, none of the above. And so thank you for your attention, and I think now it's time for questions.